we're seeing some flat tires today.
There's only 19 points between the top two.
Oh, Ryan Newman, the leader.
Caution flag is out.
Doesn't have a green light kicker.
Sure looks that way.
The race leader, Ryan Newman, right front.
Yep. Another right front tire. Just talking about it. Not over till it's over.
Never see Ryan Newman, the 12 car, going down in turn one, and the right front tire goes flat, and in that safer barrier he goes.
This has to be one of the worst things to happen as a NASCAR driver, to have your tire blow out while leading the race with only three laps to go. There have been so many instances over the years where this has happened to multiple drivers, and it's extremely frustrating to watch and have to witness the pain that they go through knowing victory was in their grasp. Well, this happened to Ryan Newman during the 2004 Homestead race.
Near perfect race car. Tommy Baldwin telling Casey, think about your race car. We should pit sometime in the next 15 laps.
It's really going away.
Looks like he's going to get it.
Trouble. Turn two.
Oh my goodness.
Casey Kane, the race leader, has hit the wall.
Oh my gosh. And we've got crashes off turn four.
Sterling Marlin and Kyle Busch.
Yeah. Boom, there it goes.
Well, something.
Yeah. Right front tire.
Right front tire.
Man, oh man.
Matt.
BP, his cousin Cole earlier said, looked like something broke. Tommy asked him, tire or does something break? He says, tire.
What a heartbreak.
Having a dominating car and not winning the race is also something extremely heartbreaking. There have been so many instances over the years that this has happened, but none will be as iconic as Casey Kane's rookie season. Casey Kane came so close to winning multiple races that year and fell into issues. The night that everybody thought he was finally going to claim that elusive first victory, it all came crashing down into turn number one as he entered turn number one and his right front tire went flat and he pancaked the outside wall, causing damage to his race car and ultimately ending his night.
Well, you may as well because you're not coming in.
Stanley, still got 6 seconds, two more to go.
So obviously they made a decision. They're going to run out or they're going to win this thing. Trying, so.
See if it'll pick up.
Don't worry about that long gear is what I'm saying, Dave.
Reed Sorensen, just one top five. Five top
tens
this year.
Oh, he's out of gas.
Year,
he's out of gas.
First out of gas, Jimmy.
And watch Casey Kane come roaring by in that red car. They gambled and lost. Casey Kane to the lead and will come to the white.
Talk about some more unlucky moments. Rookie Reed Sorensen was leading with only two laps to go at California in 2006. This would have been Reed Sorensen's first ever career victory in NASCAR. And as his career played out, this would have been his only victory in the NASCAR Cup Series. He was running out of gas entering turn one and ran out completely at the exit of turn number two, giving the win to Casey Kane and ultimately not winning that race. This was extremely heartbreaking for Reed Sorensen. One of the most devastating moments in Chase Elliott's career was when he was so close to making the final round in the playoffs in 2019. He had to have a great day at Phoenix and he was doing just that. He was actually running in second place when his right rear tire fell apart and he went and backed it into the wall, causing damage to the rear of his race car, ultimately ending his shot at making the final round in the playoffs and ending his shot at a victory. Chase Elliott was devastated after this accident.
This race changed on that green flag.
Oh, hard into the wall. Denny Hamlin from the lead slams into the wall. Again, we see a right side, right front failure, and Hamlin hard into the wall.
Catch your breath. Talk.
With only seven laps to go, Denny Hamlin's right front tire would go, and he would go hard into the outside wall, causing massive damage to his race car and erupting in flames. Denny Hamlin has never won the Brickyard 400, and this was the closest he had ever been since 2018. He had the win in sight, and with the 550 package, it was going to be extremely difficult for Kevin Harvick to mount a charge to pass him and win the race. Hamlin basically had this win in the bag, ultimately, until his tire fell apart. This was extremely heartbreaking for the 11 team.
Tires not building those air pressures up too much, and he's also, Jimmy Johnson
going
around.
Into the wall hard.
Unbelievable, our leader. shaking his head. Boy, you know he's frustrated with that. Had such a great car, great race going on.
From aerial coverage, he's pulling up for the four, pulling up on a slower car.
That's Chris Buescher in the 17. So you see Jimmy turns down low, runs all four on that apron like he's been doing. Oh, the 17 had to check up just a little bit, and Jimmy's right front made contact and turned him around.
The wins that got away from drivers have to be ones that haunt them to this day. This race has to haunt Jimmy Johnson to this day, and I can guarantee it does. Jimmy Johnson, in his final full-time season, had the fastest car at the COVID race when NASCAR came back to Darlington. He was going to win the first stage up until he wrecked himself coming off turn number two and ending his day. And he had a rocket ship of a race car.
One and two here.
Oh, there's the move. He's not going to give it up easily, though.
I don't think he can do anything about it now.
2 liter, 48. All right, baby, let's air that thing out. Don't look back.
Yeah, there was about a half a second difference last lap. From the 48 car.
Just make sure we finish it, bud.
Other Hendrick Motorsports cars with engine troubles earlier today. Inside of 6 laps to go, Johnson loses the lead, Dave.
A lap ago, he said motor laying down, and they radioed back as if they weren't sure if he was kidding or not. He's not.
And there it goes.
Might bring a caution now.
Stay on the bottom. That's it. It's dead.
You can see the water coming out of the exhaust pipe.
From leading the race with 6 laps to go to headed for the garage with 5 laps to go for Jimmy.
Continuing off of Jimmy Johnson. At the time, he had won on almost every configuration on the NASCAR circuit. He had won at every racetrack, but Michigan was one that was eluding him. He was only 6 laps to victory until his engine went up in smoke and his chances vanished.
Maybe gave me the bottom. I was like, man, this is a gift. I was going to win the race for sure. But that caution came out, and, you know, I'm fine with the new rule. And, you know, everybody's going to debate that, we were thinking before the race that they made a good change on the green-white checker to go to one, and I still feel that way. Per the rules, we run second. I can live with that. The 22 did a great job. He had a hell of a round winning all 3 races. So if he wins the championship, he can look back on this round here that set him up. I'm proud of what we did today. We did everything we needed to do. Just fell a little short about the width of the splitter. And you know how I hate that splitter. So another reason.
Exactly right. Should NASCAR have let you guys run longer under that green-white checkered before throwing the caution?
Another 100 yards, I'd have been in the lead. But NASCAR makes the calls.
Being a Dale Jr. fan growing up was one of the most painful things to experience. He was always so close to victory, but none like the 2015 Talladega Fall Race. Dale Jr. was victory, and I will die on that hill that Dale Jr. won that race. But ultimately, NASCAR gave the win to Joey Logano because they didn't have a clear camera angle of who was leading at the time of caution. This was probably one of the biggest controversial moments in NASCAR history, and ultimately, Dale Jr. got the short end of the stick.
White flag, next flag ends the race. Hamlin trying to close.
Track's clear, we're good to go.
Seven back.
Harvick third, Reagan fourth, Logano fifth. What a topsy-turvy finish to the Coca-Cola 600.
And Dale Jr. is scooting away. Uh-oh, he's slowing, isn't he?
150,000 people on their feet.
Jr. is slowing, he's out of fuel. He's out of gas.
And as at Indy, the leader at turn four does not get to the flag. Harvick, the closer, wins it.
Once again, where did he come from?
Lasky trying to make the move on Logano. Logano throws the block. Logano leads down the back straightaway.
34 is going to push on you. Over straight.
The run's on top.
Oh!
Teammate.
Horrific crash on the final lap of the Daytona 500.
Huge pile up on the final lap of the Daytona 500. Everybody has climbed from their cars.
Wreck me for the win.